going to look at the five Lutheran truths. They are printed out for you along with the passages that will form the basis for our study. Inside the worship folder, I encourage you to follow along there. We begin with Scripture alone. 2 Timothy 3, verses 15 and 16. How from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is God-breathed. It is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. Sola Scriptura. You are saved through Scripture alone. Agree or disagree? The Bible contains God's Word. What do you think? It does contain God's Word, doesn't it? But if we say that the Bible contains God's Word, doesn't that imply that some of the Bible contains God's Word? Some of it doesn't. And if that's the case, then we have a problem. Then we don't know which part of the Bible is God's Word and which part isn't. And so it might be better to say that the Bible is God's Word. All of it. And isn't that what Paul says? All Scripture is God-breathed. It's the word inspire, but not in the sense of to motivate, but literally to breathe into the Holy Spirit, breathe the words of God into human men who wrote it down. All of Scripture is God's Word, and therefore is completely true and accurate in every way. Many of you have known the Holy Scriptures from infancy. How blessed you are. Because it is through Scripture alone that you become wise for salvation. We learn about a natural knowledge of God, the idea that by nature, without being told, every human being knows there is a God. But Scripture alone reveals who the true God is, that He is Father, Son, and Spirit, three persons in yet one God. Scripture alone reveals God's plan of salvation, that God is not just an angry judge who will condemn us for our sins, but that He is our loving Father who sent His own Son to live and die for us. And through Scripture alone, the Holy Spirit gives us faith to believe that Jesus is our Savior, and therefore to become wise for salvation. So the primary use of the Bible is to give us faith in Jesus for eternal salvation. Paul says that it's also useful for daily life. It's useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, because after God makes us holy through faith in Christ, God wants us to live a holy life, and it's only by the power of His Word that we can live such lives that are pleasing to our gracious God. So we don't need to look for knowledge or wisdom anywhere else. All that we need to know is revealed in Scripture alone. And therefore, you are saved through Scripture alone. Faith alone. John 20, verse 31. But these, the Word of God, these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, or the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in His name. Sola fide, you are saved by faith alone. If you were to die in a car accident on your way home this afternoon, God forbid, and God was there and asked you, why should I let you into heaven? What would you say? Maybe you've heard the question before, but there's really only two possible answers, and the answer all hinges upon the first word, the subject of the sentence. Most people, and in fact even most churches, would teach to say, I did my best to live a good life. I didn't sin as much as the guy down the road. Or at the very least, I believe. But faith answers Jesus. Jesus lived a perfect life. Jesus died on the cross to take away all the world's sins. And Jesus rose from the dead. God led me into heaven because of Jesus. But even when we say, I believe, and we mean the right thing, we really mean to point to Jesus. gives us through God's word. That's what John says was the whole purpose of the Bible. These are written that we might believe in Jesus. And the Bible doesn't just give us knowledge about Satan and the demons know who Jesus is. But the Bible gives us faith to believe. And through faith alone, we have life in His name. You are saved by faith alone, grace alone. Ephesians 2:8 and 9. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. Sola gratia. You are saved by grace alone. Most of you, maybe all of you, learned what grace is somewhere along the way. Anybody tell me what's grace? Eliana? You're going to be shy. What's grace? Undeserved love. You ever stop and think about that? Undeserved. Maybe the closest we get to that in our human relationships is parents' love for a child. We just love them because, and often in spite of, what they do. But the world wants us to believe that there's a good reason that God loves you, that deep down inside, you are really good at heart. Your simple nature wants you to believe that there is a reason that God loves you, that God loves you because you love your family, and you work hard, and you're a good neighbor, and a good citizen, and you check off the list. And the devil even tries to deceive us that as believers, there's a reason that God loves us, because we believe. Because we attend church services, or do a Bible study, or we give offerings, or we serve on a committee, we're always looking for the checklist. But grace says that God loves us even though we don't deserve it. Because deep down inside, we are completely sinful. Every inclination of the human heart is only sinful all the time on its own. Isaiah said that even when we do the right things, even our righteous acts are like filthy rags because the best that we can offer is tainted by sin. But God doesn't love you because of who you are or because of what you do. God loves you because of who He is. God the Father loves you because He wants you. He loved you enough to send His only Son, and God the Son, Jesus Christ, loves you, period. Just because He wants you. He loves you so much that He was willing to give His own life for you. And God the Holy Spirit loves you, period, just because He wants you. And He comes to you through word and through sacrament to turn your heart of stone into a heart of flesh. And so you never have to wonder or worry if God loves you. He loves you because He wants you. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. God never changes, and so God will always love you. You are saved by grace alone. Christ alone. John 14, verse 6. Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Solas Christus. You are saved in Christ alone. Have you ever heard the old saying, all roads lead to Rome? It was actually true at one time in history because the Romans built all roads, so literally every road led to Rome. Some people think that's how faith or religion or church work. That all faiths lead to heaven. People say it doesn't really matter what you believe as long as you believe something. If you make it general enough, it really just doesn't matter if you believe anything, that everyone goes to heaven. And I don't mean to be insensitive here, but have you experienced that at funerals? Have you ever been to a funeral where somebody said, I don't know? There's an assumption that everybody goes to a better place. But that's not reality. Jesus said that there is only one road, one path, one way that leads to heaven. He is the way, the only way. because Jesus alone is the Son of God, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary to become fully human. Jesus alone was born under the law and kept it perfectly. Jesus alone died on a cross, and only through his holy, precious blood and innocent suffering and death does the blood of God pay for the sins of all people. Jesus alone, by his own power, rose from the dead and conquered death. And Jesus alone ascended into heaven and now sits at the right hand of God, ruling over all things for the good of his body, which is the church, everyone who believes in him. And Jesus alone will return on the last day to judge the living and the dead. But all who have put their faith in Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life, will be saved, because you are saved in Christ alone. Glory to God alone. Jude 1, verse 25. To the only God, our Savior, in glory, majesty, power, and authority, through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now, and forevermore. Soli Deo Gloria. To God alone, the glory. If we are indeed saved by grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone, as taught by Scripture alone, to whom else could we give glory? And yet every day when you wake up in the morning, your little sinful nature wants to find glory for itself. We want to be proud of ourselves, right? We want to do a good job, to give ourselves on a pat on the back, or maybe someone else will tell us, good job, attaboy, attagirl. Even when we're doing things for other people, we at least want them to say thank you or to recognize us. If you let somebody into that long string of cars going out of the parking lot, you at least want them to wait. And you know that you want glory because when you don't get the recognition or the admiration, or praise, that little sinful nature inside says, well, what about me? For our sinful nature is always about me. But in baptism, we put our sinful nature to death because there's nothing that we can do. There's nothing that we have done to bring glory to ourselves or God. God did everything. God sent his Son. Jesus died, and the Holy Spirit gave us faith. And so to God alone, the glory. Isn't that why God created us? To give him glory. And even when we fail to give God glory because of our sinful nature, God redeems us. He takes our sin away. He fills us with the righteousness of Christ. He clothes us with the robe of righteousness so that we can give glory to him again. And one day we will give glory to God forever in heaven along with the angels and all the hosts of heaven. But we can give God glory even today. In fact, isn't that why we gather together every week? Yes, we gather together so that God can again come to us and we confess our sins and he can again forgive us and again clothe us with his holiness. But we come together so that we can worship God. We worship God when we listen to him and when we sing to him and when we pray to him. We worship God when we go home and we continue to listen throughout the week and when we do our best to live according to his will, and when we fail, we ask for his forgiveness. To God alone be the glory, because there is nothing we can do and there is nothing we need to do. It's all done. God did it all. You are saved, sola gratia, by grace alone. You are saved sola fide, through faith alone. Solus Christus, in Christ alone. Sola Scriptura, as taught in Scripture.